You need a shell jacket when you're going into the winter, into the cold, into the outdoors. What type of shell jacket do you bring? That's what I'm going to talk about. I use my shell jacket. This is an REI event jacket when I use this for my ski expedition across Greenland. My buddy Terry Williams and I skied across Greenland, and this was the shell jacket that I used. Now, there are two primary fabrics that people either use for a hard shell. Hard meaning crinkly, it sounds like a freaking potato chip bag. And I'll tell you about the features of this jacket and why I like it. But the two fabrics, the one you probably know is Gore-Tex. Gore-Tex is the universal go-to that virtually everyone uses. However, I prefer Event fabric. Why do I prefer Event fabric over Gore-Tex? Simply because Event fabric breathes way, way better than Gore-Tex, in my humble opinion and in my experience. I've used Event jackets in Greenland twice, Antarctica, blah, 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 like every freaking wear. And what the purpose of this shell jacket is to simply keep the wind and the environment from getting inside to my inner layers. This is an outer battle shell for me, so it can take the best, most spectacular abuse ever. Now you can see the REI logo here. Let's see if I can, there you go. Now you say REI equipment, literally yes, I brought an REI jacket to Greenland, I brought it to Antarctica, Denali and all that. And I'm not saying this to brag, I'm telling you that the brand name isn't necessarily the fact. The fact is, I love the design of this jacket for multiple reasons. One, it has breast pockets that are nice and deep, and I can keep my camera and my phone and everything here. I kept my hat, everything zipped in here. That was huge, so I could keep all my junk in there. And then the zippered pockets here, I could keep everything loaded in there. And then the back comes down about mid-butt, and it covers up pretty well. The hood has draw cords here, so I can draw this bad boy down, seal myself up, and then pull this down, close it up. It's got a pull cord so I can get my hood off my face. That makes a big, big difference in my experience. And also the Event jackets tend to be way lighter than Gore-Tex. Now, they are not as warm, absolutely not. The Gore-Tex is way warmer, and the reason Gore-Tex is warmer is it simply doesn't breathe well. Hence the name of Event fabric. Now the thing about Event fabric is you gotta keep it clean like all breathable membrane jackets. But boy, I love all the variations and I have a lot of shell jackets. But my Event jacket from REI is the one that I go back to every time. They keep making them, then they quit making them. So hopefully they'll keep making this type of jacket. And it's got a ridiculously huge inner pocket here where I can put more stuff. So I walk around like the Michelin man, all ridiculous. But a jacket with tons of pockets and features. This also has pit zips. I don't like it when it rains, but when it got too hot, the pit zips were a huge salvation in Greenland, so I can literally breathe the pits out. And it made such a difference when it gets hot on my trek. So definitely consider Event fabric over Gore-Tex fabric. Because once you go Event, baby, you don't use it for warmth, you use it for shell only, and it works so much better to prevent getting hot. Please check out links below to aaronlindstedt.com/Greenland so you can get more information on all the outdoor expedition gear I use so you too can go out and enjoy the outdoors. Thank you very much for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe to the channel so you can get more info like this.